We're taking a look at the tremendous crowd here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Jam-packed to the rafters here for this World Wrestling Federation extravaganza. Gorilla Monsoon at ringside with Bobby the Brain Heenan. Plenty of action and excitement coming up. Let's go to our ring announcer.
The following is your hostess main event. It is an Intercontinental Heavyweight title matchup. Introducing first, accompanied by Elizabeth from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, the champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The reigning Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Macho Man Randy Savage, making his way down to the ring here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. But over a year now, Brain, since he, shall we say, stole the title.
Well, you and everybody else thought it was a fluke. But over 1 year, and he hasn't been a kind of a champion that just defended it when he felt like it. He defended that title.
I'll give him that. He met all newcomers for sure. Being led down by the very lovely Elizabeth. There he is in all his glory and splendor. Certainly is a beautiful robe. Spares no expense in dressing Elizabeth either.
Hey, when you're making the kind of money as the Intercontinental Champion, he doesn't care about a thing.
The challenger is from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing 236 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Say that she is very instrumental in his career.
She helps.
Would you
but
like,
he's the man that still gets in there.
Would you like the members of your family to say that about you? Well, he helped.
Well, they wouldn't say that about me. There is no Bobby Heenan family without Bobby Heenan.
Classic confrontation here between the Dragon and the Champion. Duck underneath. Oh, beautiful deep arm drag. Runs right in. And a chop waiting for, oh, look at this. The Dragon pulling out all the stops. Referee is not supposed to put his hands on the wrestler. Tide has turned just that quick. Oh, look at that beautiful move by the Dragon right through the legs. Scoops him up in a slam position. Wow, look at the speed on the Dragon. He is unreal. The Champion slithered out underneath that bottom rope. He may be headed for the locker room.
He's not that kind of a champion.
Well, he certainly appeared that way.
He was probably going to try to get an official that could back Steamboat off a bit and handle the rules here.
Elizabeth literally hiding behind the post as the Dragon brings him back the hard way. And he scoots right out again.
Good thinking. Good strategy. I like it.
Chant going out by this capacity crowd. Steamboat.
Savage. Is that the young?
Steamboat.
Oh. Stupid move, Steamboat.
Caught him on the way back in. Both of these guys extremely quick. And it's a dragon out over the top and hard down to the cement floor here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Not the place to be.
Maple Leaf Garden or the floor?
Both. Don't ever be on the floor in any arena. You can't win from down there. Look at this. Ramming him right shoulder first into this. I can't believe that he didn't go for the neck on that move.
He's going for it. He's just getting ready. This is a champion you're talking about. He's going to get him right where he wants him and then finish the man off.
Certainly would be nice to see a title change hands here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Talking about the Intercontinental title. Boy, he's good at that back shot, isn't he?
Shot's a shot. Take him when you can. I hope Mrs. Steamboat is here with him. So maybe after this match is over, she can translate to the cab driver how to get back to the hotel, because I don't think he's going to be able to talk.
Look out. Ooh. Wow. Slammed once again on the floor. And Macho Man just bailing in time to stop the count. Oh, he'll settle for a count out. He wouldn't mind having a dragon counted out.
Take it any way you can. I think he'd like to hurt him a little more.
The dragon undoubtedly wanted the gold, but that may be secondary. It's vendetta time. It's payback time.
That's why he'll never be champion. He doesn't think like a champion. Look at him. He's crawling out of the building. He's crawling out of the building. What a disgrace.
What do you mean he's crawling out of the building?
I think he's looking for the exit.
Savage once again. Now dragging the dragon back in. Nope. Changed his mind. Oh, now he's going for the neck. Now he's going for the esophagus area. The area that literally put Ricky the Dragon Steamboat on the shelf here for quite some time, and many thought he would never be back. Where's Savage going now? To the outside, with ease, to the top turnbuckle, bombs away, he nailed him with it. Double axe handle, right to the back of the base of the brain. Savage pulling out all the stops. Hooks now with a double hook up of the legs and still can only get a two count. And a testament to the intestinal fortitude of the dragon. Wow.
There we go.
Macho Man resorting to what I thought he'd start using right off the bat, attacking the neck area.
See, that's probably what Steamboat thought.
Tights.
In my book, he had him there.
Well, he should have had him. He had a handful of tights. But the dragon, nice block. And the tide has turned again in this matchup. Irish whip, no, reversal. Steamboat hard in the corner. Nice clothesline by the champion. Definitely a thinking man's champion, thinking all the time.
That's what I said. Strength is a lot. Knowing where you are is a lot. Positioning's a lot. Endurance. But you don't have any brains, forget it. You're lost.
Really doing the work now, methodically setting up Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Oh, went for the coup de grace, got caught. That peripheral vision on the part of the dragon enabled him to see him coming, and at the last split second got out of the way, and once again the tide has turned.
Poor dumb luck.
Couldn't hold him up there. Wow, that was close.
If that guy had been there in time, the referee had been in position in time, we'd have had a count of three.
If is a very big, big two-letter word.
Oh, it sure is.
Nice shot right over the shoulder of the lovely Elizabeth, who has to be concerned right now at this particular point in time with the way this match is going.
Is that a choke?
No, that's not a choke.
I just asked.
You don't see the arm underneath the throat, do you?
Right there, I do.
That's a chin lock right there. Savage appears to be partially busted open there. Does it appear that way to you, Brian?
Yeah, it does.
Referee asking Terry Orson, asking if he wants to give it up. I don't think the Macho Man is a quitter. Look at this.
Randy, he's behind you, Randy.
He hung up on that top rope.
Wow. What a move. That's why he's a champion. That's why this man is the Intercontinental Champion.
He just looked over at the brain and said, yes, I'm going to go to work on the throat right now, buddy. Look at this, out into the ringside area. Savage got the Dragon right where he wants him. Caught up here.
He's trying to crawl out. I'm telling you, the Dragon's running for his life.
That's still, oh, look at this. He draped his neck.
Deja vu.
Top of the steel barricade.
He's going up.
Champion now going to the top. Elizabeth looking on. Bombs away. Oh, he got caught. A Dragon caught him right in the middle of that move. Another turning point in this match. Oh. Blood definitely coming out of the facial area of the champion.
But he still comes back and fights. He's still a champion.
Irish whip in. Look out. Duck underneath. A nice deep arm drag by the challenger. Through the legs. The Dragon's on fire. The adrenaline flowing in his body. That's a chokehold, ref.
Come on, referee, disqualify him.
No, I didn't say disqualify.
That's what I said. The man should be disqualified.
Give the guy a count. Referee is not supposed to, once again, put his hands on the wrestlers.
Oh, you don't think that dumb Hawaiian can count to four or five, do you?
Oh, look at this. He's going to snap him right on that top rope. And the crowd loving it. Dragon showing everybody exactly what part of the body he's going to go to work on. Clothesline City coming up. Well, lucky for the champion, he had both hands on that top rope. Took a lot of the steam out of that particular move.
Boy, does Elizabeth look worried. Look at her.
Can't see her. She's out of my picture right now.
I don't think she's got any nails left.
Dragon really going to work. He wants to go out after him. Action going to the front. Oh, nice block by the Dragon. And he blocked it again. Referee laying the count on both men. And it's Savage who's rammed into the steel railing. We could see history made right here tonight in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens as once again the pendulum has swung in this match. And there's the concerned look on the face of Elizabeth. And it's a Dragon.
Behind you. Behind you, Andy.
Whoa, what a tomahawk chop from that top turnbuckle. This could be all she wrote. Slingshot. Right into the steel post. What a tremendous matchup.
He's definitely opened up now.
He's busted wide open. The crimson streaming down the face of the champion.
He should stop the match right now and award it to Savage.
For what?
He ran the man into the steel post. It's uncalled for.
That's what Savage has been doing since this match began. All of a sudden now it's a constituted disqualification. Elizabeth very concerned at this point. And I don't blame her. Macho Man staggering around, trying to find his way out of here. Dragon saying nothing doing. Oh, nice leverage move right out of nowhere.
See, he's still the champion. He still has enough left in him to come back when he has to.
The Dragon, completely surprised by that move, came down right on his tailbone. And now both men out on the runway. High knee right to the back of the Dragon. But the champion is still in deep trouble.
Come on, get in and beat the count.
Doesn't look much like a champion right now, does he?
Well, he's standing, the other punk isn't. He's gonna beat the count, he's gonna do it. Come on, ref, after 10.
You wanna be a referee now?
I can certainly do a lot better than this, Hammond Egger.
The Dragon once again back to his feet. Shoulder block from the outside. High sunset flip. But the champion's gonna hold it on top turnbuckle. He turned it loose. 1-2. No, he couldn't get it. Roll up from the backside. 2 count again. And roll up once more. Can't hold his shoulders down.
Well, he's trying everything.
Small package. Oh, look at that. Savage realizing how much trouble he's in. Took a shot at the referee. Oh, look at this. With two hands full of tights.
He got him. He got him. Ha, ha, ha.
I can't believe it.
He's a champion. That's why he's a champion.
Why? Because he reached in and pulled the guy's tights.
Because when it had to be done, he went and did it.
The Dragon obviously not satisfied with what's gone down here, and I don't blame him. Still going to work. But Savage will leave this building, this Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, with the gold still intact. And the Dragon hot on his trail right now. He didn't let him make it. Look at that, the champion busted wide open.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Got a nice ring to it, don't it?
The thief, he stole another one. Stole it from the referee, stole it from Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Hey, pineapple breath. How you like that, punk? Back to Maui.
A moral victory here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Let's go back and take a look at what the champion had to resort to in order to get a victory.
He wasn't swinging at the referee. He couldn't see. He was blinded by the blood.
Look at this. Right into the tights. And as the roll-up came around, he put both hands inside. Where's the referee counting from anyway?
I'll take it. Three counts to three counts, as far as I'm concerned.
I guess you will. You and the rest of the guys in your stable, along with the Macho Man Randy Savage and Elizabeth.
The hand is raised.
We'll be back.
Looks good to me.